In this video, we're going to look at one of the key factors affecting tension development in skeletal muscle, and that is the initial length of those muscles. In other words, what is the resting length of the sarcomeres before we stimulate that muscle to contract? That will be a factor in determining how much tension those sarcomeres can develop. And so what we see down here in A is that we're graphing muscle tension relative to the length of the sarcomere, right? So our sarcomere increasing in length as we go to the right here, our initial starting length of the sarcomere pre-stimulation. And so what we find is that at very short lengths of the sarcomere, and we've got a sarcomere sort of blown up here, showing you what's happening, right? So here we've got a Z disc. Over here, we've got a Z disc, right? Anchoring our thin filaments. In the middle here, we have an M line anchoring our thick filaments, our myosin filaments. And you can see the little crossbridges sticking out off of those thick filaments. And what we have at very short initial sarcomere lengths is the thick filament is sort of jammed up against the Z disc, right? And we end up with sort of interference with normal interaction between those myosin heads and the thin filament. And if you think about it, we would be shortening even more from this state once we initiate contraction. And so it's very, very difficult to generate significant tension, and we don't get a lot of it. Now, as we stretch, right, as we stretch a muscle passively and then stimulate it, if we stretch it, we pull those thick filaments out from in between the thin filaments a little bit, and we get more optimal overlap. Remember, the zone of overlap is sort of that key region where cross bridges can form. And so our zone of overlap has gotten better. We get more cross bridges here at increased resting length. Once we stimulate, we'll get a stronger contraction. And then, of course, there's an optimal resting length where we get, you know, sort of key ideal overlap between thick and thin filaments, right? We have room to sort of slide into this towards the Z disc, and we're going to get our best tension development in this range of length. Now, if we go beyond that length, if we keep increasing our length beyond that, we start to pull our thick filaments out from between our thin filaments, reducing our zone of overlap. Well, that, of course, minimizes cross-bridge formation development, starting to reduce the amount of tension we're going to develop when we stimulate contraction. If we go to an extreme, this is very difficult to do, actually, except experimentally, and actually stretch those sarcomeres till the thick filaments are no longer overlapping, then of course we're going to get essentially no tension at all. Now, one thing is key to remind you of here is that this is active tension. This is tension developed by stimulating the sarcomeres to form cross bridges and generate tension, right? And that's actually indicated by this active tension curve up here, also in green. But there are other structures that also would generate tension as you increase pull on this muscle or muscle cell. You know, the connective tissues and the cells themselves would generate resistance and generate tension, and that's passive tension. And so if you look at total tension in this darker line, we can see that it goes up as we stretch those sarcomeres and then falls off again as we would reduce our amount of overlap, as we saw here. But then at very high stretched lengths, that tension starts to rise again just because you're putting so much tension into those non-contractile elements. Now, the good news is we tend to stay within a working range of a muscle limited by the joints themselves. It's sort of in this range, right, where it's very hard to sort of overstretch a muscle to the point where it becomes impossible to generate very strong contractions.